Build a trading platform in C# part 3, send order. And I added a few things from the last part, the second part, which was the streaming data. I added a few buttons and text boxes. I added one here for the order ID, disconnect button, sell, buy, a checkbox for outside regular trading hours, and a timer. Okay, the first thing you want to do is click on your text box for your valid ID and go over here to your properties and give it a text value of 0 and a name. In the name of text box valid underscore ID, like TB valid ID with a capital V and a capital I here, just make it look like mine. Next, on the disconnect button, text will be disconnect and BTN disconnect. Okay, on the sell button here, you want to name it sell, of course, and the text value will be sell. And the name will be BTN sell, just like mine, with a capital S. And you can also change the background color by clicking on this here, changing it to whatever you want. I have it set to red, so I'm not going to change it. And the four colors set to white, and the font you can change here by clicking this button with the three dots on it. I changed mine to bold and set the font size to 12. Okay, do that for the buy button. Back color green, foreground color white, font bold and 12. And the text value is buy, of course. And the name will be BTN buy. Want to do is double click on the disconnect button here and put this in here, the right here, this IB client socket e disconnect with the closing brackets, and go back to your form. Okay, on the sell button here, double click on it and create a string variable called side and set its value to sell. And this is a call to a method, and you're sending this variable off to that method. Okay, do the same thing for the buy button. String value side, set it to buy, of course, and call that method like we did in this sell button event. Okay, you want to create this method here, send order, which accepts the value of side from your click event. Create a contract, get the symbol from the combo box here. Security type will be stock. Exchange will be smart, of course, which you can get from the combo box market text. Primary exchange will be island. Currency will be US dollars. And then you create the order, and you need an order ID, and we have to set the variable up. I'll do that later when I'm finishing explaining this. Okay, the side is buy or sell for the action, which we got from the click event and sent it to the method. The order type is like, say, limit, market, or stop order. You get that from that text or combo box. The quantity is the number of shares you want to trade. You get that for the numeric up down box, the value. And the limit price, you get that from the little limit price numeric up down box value for it, you have to change it to a double. You have to change the quantity also up here to a double too, or convert it. Okay, this part here, it checks to see if your order type is stop. If it is, it needs the auxiliary price, and you get that from the limit price box, the numeric up down box. If it's not a stop order, it just ignores that because you don't need the auxiliary price. Then we go to the display size. You don't actually need this either, but I like to have it in here. Number of shares visible. I have it set to 100 all the time. And this one checks to see if the checkbox is checked or not. And if it is checked and you're trading pre-market or after hours, then you can trade. Otherwise, if it's not checked, you can't. But if it's checked or not checked in regular hours, it doesn't matter. It'll still work. Okay, then we place the order with the order ID number, the contract that we created up here, under contract here, and the order which we created here. And once that goes through, it gets sent to the API. And then we increase the order ID number, and we add that to the valid ID text box on our form. Okay, I told you earlier that I needed to make this variable. So you go up to the top here and put that in here just under class form one. It has to be an integer. I called it order ID and set it to 0. And this timer counter here, we're going to need that for later, so you might as well put that in there now. It has to be an integer, and the value should be 5. Okay, go back to your design, your form design. Okay, click on the bid text box here, and go to your properties, and click on this lightning bolt, which is the event. Scroll up to the top here and double click on click for the click event. And here you want to get the amount that's in the text box for the bid, and you want to put it in the limit box. So when you click on it, that price gets transferred. And do the same thing for the ask. Okay, and the same thing for the last. Okay. Back to your design. Okay, click on outside regular trading hours here. Make sure you put a checkbox in there. And the checkbox is up here. So click on that and put it onto your form. And your properties, make sure the properties for the text is outside RTH. You can actually make that anything you want. But make sure the actual text or the actual name is CHK outside. Okay, make sure you add your timer. Your timer is located down here. Just click on it and add it here, and it'll automatically put it down here. But mine's already there, so just delete that. Click on the timer and make sure it says timer 1. It should already. Shouldn't have to change anything. Okay, now double click on your timer. And this event here will count down from 5. And once it reaches 0, it will stop the timer and put the text box bid price, the bid price, into the limit price box, so it's not sitting at zero when you change from stock to stock. And then it resets the timer back to 5, and this counts down every time you get a tick. Okay, also in here you want to get the order ID from the API or the trader workstation, and then you want to send it to the text box on your form, and then you can do that and set the variable order ID to that number. Okay, from here hit start and then connect. My Traders Workstation is working in the background, and so you want to minimize this, the Visual Studio. I'll bring this over so you can see it. This is Interactive Brokers. And we're going to make a trade here. A limit order. Buy 100 shares. Okay, we'll cancel that. Later on, I'll make a cancel button so you don't have to go back to your Interactive Brokers to cancel it. Okay, now I'll do a market order. Buy 100 shares. I'll do a stop order. Here's your stop order. Cancel that. Now I'll just get rid of the shares. Market. Sell 100. Okay, Microsoft is sold. Okay, so now if you want to change the bid, ask, or last price and put that amount in the limit price, you just click on one of these. That's what that click event was that we set up. And so when you change symbols also, say IBM, the countdown timer automatically puts the bid price in the limit price box here. And one other thing I want to show you is the connection for trade ideas. You can set that up if you have trade ideas to your platform here. Just go to Tools, External Linking, hit Add Link. And hover your mouse pointer over the comma box for symbol and hit shift and then say okay here and then press close. So now when I click on a symbol over here like GameStop, it'll automatically send it to my platform here, this form one. Do another one. Same thing. So then you can make a trade from there. And also there's where the next valid order ID is that we set up earlier too. Okay, please like and subscribe, and if you missed any of the code, I will post it on my blog, sharpertradingimage.blogspot.com. Thanks for watching. I'll try and do more videos, so stay tuned. Thanks, bye.